Today is a wonderful day. Today is the Lord's day. And God is such a big God that God doesn't even get jealous when society even refers to it as Mother's Day. So even on Mother's Day, God understands that those that love Him still understand under the umbrella of Mother's Day, it is still the Lord's Day. God says, I'm not jealous. Enjoy your mothers. God says, I'm not jealous. Enjoy your mothers. Amen. Because those of us who've been born again know that even in times, God has been a mother and a father in our lives. Amen. So let me say to all the mothers, when I say mothers, I'm not talking about women who have just necessarily given birth biologically to a child, but if you've been an influence in someone's life to help raise and nurture them, you're a mother. Amen. Amen. And I would like, if you're able and you're willing, or is it willing and able? If you're willing and able. Sometimes we're willing but not able. Sometimes we're able and not willing. But if you are willing and you're able, it would be good for us men and young women to see all the mothers who are here this morning. If you don't mind, just stand up real quickly. Let us see you. And if you nurtured a child, not biologically, stand up. Look around you. Let's give our mothers a hand. Happy Mother's Day to all of them. One, two, three.
Happy Mother's Day.
Bless your heart. Next month is Father's Day. Now, let me share something with you. It's really good to see all of you. I want to encourage you to turn your Bibles to Ephesians chapter 2. I want to welcome all of our visitors who are here with us, who are passing through and sharing in our worship service this morning. We want you to know that you are our honored guests. And in a little while, we would like to get to know you more personally, that we may put a name with a face. Now, being that today is Mother's Day, we know you have a busy day. I shared with the Bible study class that if you didn't already have plans today, that the preacher was going to take you out to dinner. But because you already got plans, we'll do it another time. Which I ain't got no plans. You got plans. That today is Mother's Day, and we read Ephesians chapter 2. You're probably trying to figure out, you know, how you gonna get a Mother's Day lesson out of Ephesians chapter 2. Someone stopped me on Wednesday as I was walking back to my office and said, Brother Jackson, you gonna be kind to a Sunday? I said, Sister, what do you mean? She said, you know, last year, we preached a Mother's Day sermon about the bad mothers. And so we talked about Hagar and Sarah and all that. She said, last year you talked about the bad mothers. She said, you gonna be nice to us this time? See, here's the struggle I have. I really don't have, like, Mother's Day sermons and Father's Day sermons. I just have sermons. And that's why I wanted to make sure that we address the mothers first. But I can almost guarantee you, if we walk through this text together, we'll be able to find some joy of being a mother. Amen. Because there's more than mothers here that still need a word.
Amen.
Amen. There are some fathers that need to be thankful that the children have a mother.
Amen.
Children that need to be thankful that mother is there.
Amen.
Mothers that should be thankful that God has blessed them. Amen. So we're all in here together. And we're going to find ourselves in Ephesians chapter 2. And if you don't find the good mother in Ephesians 2, you weren't looking. She's in there. Amen. She's in there. I say the good mother is in Ephesians 2. Y'all don't believe it. I'm going to show it to you. In Ephesians chapter 2, beginning at verse number 1, we're going to terminate at verse number 10. You got your, bless your heart. Don't do it. Okay. Brother Halton, high tech. Brother Halton, high tech. I said Ephesians chapter 2, Brother Hawkins pulled up his phone. I'm thinking he's getting ready to make a phone call. He turned around, there's the Bible. Bless you. A high-tech bishop. That's all right. I'm going to preach from my phone. Preach from my phone. Tell it too much. In your heart of hearts, are we ready to study the word?
Yes.
I encourage you to turn your Bibles to Ephesians chapter 2, beginning at verse number 1, reading from the New American Standard Bible. But if you have a reliable translation, you won't have any challenges with this text. Paul writes to the children at Ephesus and says, "And you were dead in your trespasses and sins." You write in your Bible, I would encourage you to underline trespasses and sins. Church, just the mere fact that he mentions both of them indicates there's a difference between trespasses and sins. "And you were dead in your trespasses and sins, in which you formerly walked according to the course of this world, according to the prince of the power of the air, of the spirit that is now working in the sons of disobedience. Among them, we too," y'all see how he included himself, "we too all formerly lived in the lust of our flesh, indulge in the desires of the flesh and of the mind, and were by nature children of wrath, even as the rest. But God," underline, "but God, being rich in mercy, because of his great love with which he loved us, even when we were dead in our transgressions, made us alive together with Christ. By grace you have been saved, raised us up with him, and seated us with him in the heavenly places in Christ Jesus, in order that in the ages to come we might show the surpassing riches of his grace and kindness toward us in Christ Jesus. For by grace you have been saved through faith, and that not of yourselves, it is the gift of God, not as a result of works that no one should boast. For we are his workmanship, created in Christ Jesus for good works, which God prepared beforehand that we should walk in them." Chapter 2.